रेडी स्टार्ट. दिस इज अ सूट फॉर रिकवरी ऑफ अमाउंट ऑफ रुपीज 1 लाख विथ 18% इंटरेस्ट पर ॲनम पॅरा. द केस ऑफ प्लेंटिफ इन शॉर्ट इज ॲज अंडर. द प्लेंटिफ अँड डिफेंडंट आर वेल अक्वेंटेड विथ ईच अदर. द प्लेंटिफ इज वर्किंग as a contractor in bracket mukadam for providing the laborers to the sugar factory. The defendant and his wife are the sugar cane cutting laborers. On 5th June 2010, the plaintiff and defendant entered into a contract that the defendant and his wife would work as a laborer with the plaintiff for sugar cane cutting at Kailash Sugar Works Limited, Chandwad, for the season 2010-11. As per this contract, the defendant received an advance amount of rupees 1 lakh. The defendant has signed the acknowledgement cum receipt on 5th June 2010. The written agreement was executed before a notary public. The amount of rupees 1 lakh was paid before the witnesses Kailash and Ramhari para. As per the agreement, the defendant must have to come with the plaintiff for the sugarcane cutting. However, the defendant refused to come for the said work. Therefore, the plaintiff sent a notice to the defendant either to come for work or to repay the amount of rupees 1 lakh with 18% interest. However, the defendant sent a false reply and refused to pay the amount. Therefore, the plaintiff has filed present suit for recovery of amount of rupees 1 lakh with 18% interest para. The suit summons is duly served to the defendant. He appeared and filed a written statement at Exhibit 27, para. The case of defendant, in short, is as under, para. The defendant submitted that he is working as a laborer for sugarcane cutting for a sugar factory on each year. He submitted that the plaintiff had approached him and requested him to work as a laborer and assured to pay advance amount of rupees 1 lakh. The defendant agreed to said proposal. Thereafter, the plaintiff paid amount of rupees 50,000 to the defendant and assured that remaining amount of rupees 50,000 will be paid at his house. On this pretext, the plaintiff got executed the stamp before notary public by mentioning the amount of rupees 1 lakh. After reaching at home, the defendant demanded remaining amount of rupees 50,000 to the plaintiff, but the plaintiff did not pay the remaining amount of rupees 50,000. The defendant thereafter demanded said amount on various occasions, but the plaintiff did not pay the said amount. Therefore, the defendant went to the plaintiff on 5th January 2010 and repaid the amount of rupees 50,000 received by him from the plaintiff in presence of Kailash and Ramhari. Therefore, the contract comes to an end. Now the defendant is not liable to pay any amount to the plaintiff. He has sent a reply to the notice issued by the plaintiff and clarified the entire event. Considering all these grounds, the defendant prayed for dismissal of the suit para. I heard learned advocate Sri Khataad for the plaintiff and learned advocate Sri Pawar for the defendant. I have drawn the issues at Exhibit 20. After hearing the final arguments, now I record my findings thereon with reasons as under para. Considering all these reasons, the theory put up by the defendant that he had repaid the amount of rupees 50,000 does not appear to be probable and reliable. On the contrary, on the basis of oral as well as the documentary evidence, the fact that the plaintiff had entered into contract with the defendant whereby the defendant agreed to do the labor work of sugarcane cutting and had received an advance amount of rupees 1 lakh is duly proved. Therefore, I answer issues number 1 and 2 in the affirmative and issue number 3 in the negative para. As to issue number 4 and 5, both these issues are interlinked with each other. Therefore, in order to avoid the repetition and for the sake of brevity, both these issues are taken together for the discussion para. The defendant has deposed that he has repaid the amount of rupees 50,000 to the plaintiff and annulled the agreement. However, as stated above, the theory put up by the defendant has not been proved. It clearly shows that the defendant did not act as per the terms of agreement and he did not go for doing the labor work with the plaintiff. DW number 2 has also admitted that the defendant did not go for doing the labor work with the plaintiff. The conduct of the defendant is self-explanatory that he has committed the breach of contract dated 5th June 2010. In this situation, the plaintiff must be said to be entitled to the recovery of an amount of rupees 1 lakh from the defendant. Therefore, I answer issues number 4 and 5 in the affirmative.